All right, hello, happy Wednesday. Today we're going to be talking about John Deere. Today we're going to be looking at an Encyclopedia for Kids website where we're just going to read through it and talk about who John Deere was. So first, as a little introduction, he was born February 7th, 1804, and he died May 17th, 1886. And he was an American blacksmith and inventor. So he would work a lot with his hands. He started Deere and Company, which is a big company that makes farm equipment. In 1837, he invented the first successful steel plow. So the difference is steel worked better on the tough soil of the Midwestern United States. So the Midwest is going to be in the middle of the United States, and they had rougher, tougher soil. So it was harder to dig up the soil and plant their crops. So they needed something to help dig through and make the soil loose. And steel helped. So John Deere was born in Rutland, Vermont, after a brief educational period at Middlebury College at age 17. In 1821, he began an apprenticeship with a successful Middlebury blacksmith. Also, we're going to pause right here. If you have a piece of paper and a pencil, I want you to grab that and I want you to take notes because that way, when we go back to our homework in IXL, we don't have to go back and watch the video again. We can look back at our notes. And we would be taking notes if we were in school, if we were in person, so we should practice also while we're at home. Oh, so now we're right up here where my mouse is, and entered the trade for himself in 1826. He got married in 1827 and had nine children. John was smart and hardworking, and he easily found work as a blacksmith. There were lots of farmers in Illinois, and John had to fix their plows. The new farmers in Illinois struggled to turn heavy, sticky prairie soil with cast iron plows, designed for the light, sandy soil of Vermont. John thought about the steel needles he had seen in father's tailor shop. The needles stayed smooth and shiny because they were pulled through rough leather. John Deere came up with the idea for a plow that would work. The plow in his mind was polished and shiny and made of steel, just like his father's tailoring needles. It was shaped so that it could scour itself as it cut furrows. In 1837, he carried his plow using a broken saw. He created his plow using a broken saw blade. So, real quick, I'm going to show you the map to show you where he was born and where he lives now. So this is Vermont right here. So this is where John Deere was born, and then he moved, remember, to the Midwest. So the soil here was harder than the soil here was sandy. So right here, this would be the Midwest. It's kind of in the middle. Now John sold his first plow to a farmer named Lewis Crandall. Lewis saw that the plow worked very well and told lots of other farmers. By 1841, John was making 100 of the plows every year. And by 1848, 7 years later, John had moved the business to Moline, Illinois. Now this had water power, coal, and cheaper transportation than in Grand Detour. In 1850, John's company made 1,600 plows. The company was soon producing other tools to go with the steel plow. So, just by word of mouth, when he made something that was good, other people started telling everyone else, and then his company just grew. So, his company is getting bigger and bigger. Later in life, Deere focused most of his attention on civil and political affairs. He served as president of the National Bank of Moline, a director of the Free Public Library, and was a trustee of the First Congregational Church. Deer also served as Moline's mayor for 2 years, but due to chest pain, he refused to run for a second term. He retired in 1857, leaving the operation to his son. John stayed on as president of the company, and in 1868, the company was formally incorporated as Deer & Company. Today, it is the leading manufacturer of agricultural machinery in the world, and he died at his home on May 17th. So he made this amazing company to help farmers, to help them grow plants and crops, which was very nice. So now we're going to go and I'm going to show you some pictures of some John Deere tractors and what they sell now. So this was when they first started. This was their logo between 1876 and 1912. This is their logo from 1912 to 1936. And this is what the tractor looks like. So they are known for being green and yellow. All right, so here's a picture of the tractor. And as we can see below, that's helping bring up the soil so it's easier to plant. All right, and here are just some other pictures of what they sell now in the company and how it's grown a lot since it's been started. So here we go. Here's, and right here we can see John Deere on all of the tractors. And right here, if you can look closely, there's a deer. I think I can zoom in. I cannot, never mind. All right, and that ends our lesson today on John Deere. So log on to your iXL and you will see the standard for your homework under teacher suggested skills. All right, thank you.